It's 1918. After 4 years of brutal trench warfare and millions of deaths, a peaceful agreement is achieved. For years of brutal combat in Russia and France have proved detrimental to the German economy, government, and will to fight. While initially the Germans saw tremendous success fighting Russia, France, and Britain, all at the same time, when the USA joined the war on the opposite side, it was too much for Germany. No amount of military skill could fight against overwhelming force and power. In June 1919, the great powers that fought in the Great War met at the ancient French city of Versailles. There, a peace agreement is formed. France and Great Britain were humiliated because they fought against Germany for 4 years while outnumbering them. And only one wants a civil war in Germany, and the addition of America to the war made them sue for peace. France and Britain now took their turn to humiliate Germany. Germany is forced to demilitarize its border with France. Germany is forced to take all the blame for World War I, even though it was started by Serbia. Germany is forced to give up all their African colonies and the lands of Alsace, Lorraine, and Prussia. And most significantly, Germany is forced to pay 132 billion gold marks to France. Needless to say, the German economy, government, and people were completely destroyed by World War I. After the war, the former government of Germany, the Kaiserreich monarch, was also forced to forfeit in power. Because of this, Germany gains a new government, the Weimar Republic. The Weimar Republic was democratic, which introduced many more civil freedoms in Germany. However, the Weimars inherited German governing at a very precarious time. The Weimar Republic had full responsibility for paying off the insurmountable reparations gained after World War I. It would take only 4 years for the Weimar Republic to screw up the German economy nearly beyond repair. In 1923, German employment rates were extremely low, leading to many consumer goods factories having a lack of laborers. This meant consumer products like dairy, meat, wheat, and other daily products were becoming extremely scarce and high in price. To combat this, the Weimar government decided to begin printing more money. Initially, this worked and also made it easier to pay off war debt. However, if you have ever taken an economics class, you should know how this ends for Germany. In 1923, Germany experienced massive hyperinflation. By the end of the year, a single loaf of bread cost 200 billion German marks. Banknotes in Germany became so worthless that people began burning them for heat during the winter. This economic stagnation would be amplified when Belgium and France occupied the German industrial zones of the Rhineland and Mosland, after Germany's failure to pay expected reparations. These industrial zones had many important factories and mines that were vital to German economic reconstruction. This situation would not improve until 1924, when an economic expert known as Gustav Stresemann revitalized the German economy by abolishing the ineffective Marx currency and creating a new currency, the Reichsmark. This economic revitalization was also increased when the Dawes Plan was enacted. The Dawes Plan was when American banks gave Germany $25 billion to help with war reparations and economic reconstruction. Both of these factors, and some others, led to a massive economic boom. This economic boom would be called the Roaring Twenties, a period of cultural exploration and economic prosperity in Germany. Germany during this time had exciting nightlife, rampant gambling, and legalized prostitution. The best comparable situation to this is 1970s Broadway, or LA. These Roaring Twenties would not last forever. In 1929, a global recession started. The Great Depression American loans were demanded to be paid immediately. 6.2 million German workers lost their jobs. French reparations had higher demands to be paid. And although money now had value in Germany, it was now extremely difficult to get money. Nearly all work done to revitalize the German economy was destroyed by the end of 1929. And needless to say, the German public was angry, especially at the Weimar government. Someone needed to be blamed for this economic crisis. Workers went on strike. And new political parties began lobbying as better alternatives than the Weimar government. In 1933, when voting began for a new Chancellor of Germany, a formerly underground and obscure political party rose extremely high in the polls. The NSDAP, the National Socialist German Workers' Party. The NSDAP gained this popularity using a strategy of convincing and emotionally appealing radio, television, and public services. These services would include speeches, commercials, and propaganda posters. However, the most effective of these were the speeches. The leader of the NSDAP was Adolf Hitler. Hitler was an extremely adept public speaker. He knew exactly what the German people wanted to hear.
Der Völkerstreit und Hass untereinander. Wird gepflegt von ganz bestimmten Interessenten. Es ist eine kleine, wurzellose, internationale Clique, die die Völker gegeneinander hetzt, die nicht will, dass sie zur Ruhe kommen. Es sind das die Menschen, die überall und nirgends zu Hause sind, die nirgends einen Boden haben, auf dem sie gewachsen sind, sondern die heute in Berlin leben, morgen genauso gut in Brüssel sein können, übermorgen in Paris oder wieder in Prag oder in Wien oder in London und die sich überall zu Hause fühlen. Es sind die Einzigen, die wirklich als internationale Elemente anzusprechen sind, weil sie überall ihre Geschäfte betätigen können. Aber das Volk kann ihnen ja nicht nachfolgen. Das Volk ist ja gekettet an seinen Boden, ist ja gekettet an seine Heimat, ist ja gebunden an die Lebensmöglichkeiten seines Staates, der Nation.
Nicht die intellektuellen Schichten haben mir den Mut gegeben, dieses gigantische Werk zu beginnen. Sondern das kann ich sagen, den Mut habe ich nur gefasst, weil ich zwei Schichten kannte, den Bauer und den deutschen Arbeiter. Vielleicht wird manch unter Ihnen sein, der es mir nicht verzeihen kann, dass ich die marxistischen Parteien vernichtete. Aber mein Freund, ich habe die anderen genauso vernichtet. Sie sind
Hitler, in this television speech, uses the workers and the struggling German population as a crutch for the main thesis of his political campaign. In the speech, you hear him mention multiple times how the Ashkenazi Jews are essentially responsible for the banking crisis, as they have banks everywhere and business everywhere. According to Hitler, at least, these claims gain Hitler support, as the population wanted to blame anyone but themselves for the German economic collapse after the Great Depression. And in 1933, after 6 months of voting, the NSDAP rises to power in Germany.
Mein Lebenskampf ist nicht umsonst gekämpft. Sein Sowjetzeigen soll er vor sich hertragen und wir werden in unserem Zeichen wieder siegen.